A very good afternoon to one and all. I'm Dr. Gitanshu, convener for the Institution Innovation Council, Tirthankar Mahavir University, Muradabad. I extend a warm welcome to our guest speaker for the day, Mr. Rachit Agarwal, Dr. Manjula Jain, Associate Dean Academics and President of the IIC TMU, and all the patrons attending the session. I take immense pleasure in introducing our meritorious guest speaker for today, Mr. Rachit Agarwal. He is the founder, director, and CEO of United Resourcing Private Limited, Muradabad, founder, director, and CEO of United Republic Services Private Limited, New Delhi. He has worked as a deputy manager, North Zone of Skilling and Education Initiative at Reliance Group, New Delhi, and branch manager at Farewell Service Securities Limited. He has a bachelor's degree in business and has pursued MBA and MCom post that. He also holds a doctorate in research degree in finance. He is also NCFM certified derivative capital market consultant, mutual fund advisor, and technical analyst. He has more than 10 years of experience in financial portfolios management and education industry. He has executed various strategic consulting sessions independently and jointly with reputed sectors like ITM Dehradun, Mahindra Skills Private Limited, TMU Muradabad, National Skills Development Corporation, with the gems and the jewelry sector, banking and financial services, telecom sectors. We are very appreciative and thankful to Mr. Rachit Agarwal for conducting this session for us on My Story, Motivational Session by Successful Entrepreneur, Startup Founder. It will definitely pave a way for young minds to a startup journey. Now, I kindly request Mr. Rachit to commence the session. Over to you, Rachit.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much for sharing my profile. And good afternoon, everyone. And before starting up the session, we all should be thankful to Almighty God that we should know that after this pandemic, that we are fortunate that we all are here. We are healthy, we are happy, and we are wishing that this new year will be a successful year for everyone. It should be a healthier year. It should be a progressive year for everyone. So we have overcome that pandemic session, and now we are onto the normal track. So we should be thankful to the Almighty God that we all are together here and such a wonderful platform. So moving ahead, first of all, I congratulate the entire team of Tirthankar Mahavir University Innovation Cell for conducting such a wonderful platform for our students for their learning and providing the opportunity to learn from the industry. So I congratulate Honorable Dr. Manjula Jain ma'am, Honorable Dr. Gitanshu ma'am for conducting a wonderful session and creating the innovation cell, which is in a visionary approach of the central government as well. As our government is focusing for the innovation and entrepreneurship from so long, so Tirthankar Mahavir University and its team are sharing the vision of the government for doing that innovation and entrepreneurship for their kids and students. So I congratulate. Even the university is working and joining hands with the government, which is the vision of AICT, Ministry of Education, AICT, Ministry of Education and Innovation, Institute Innovation Cell, to conducting the various sessions for the students to provide the practical knowledge related to their field. So today we are going to discuss a live practical session. So before starting up, again, I am thankful for choosing a wonderful topic, that is My Journey, My Story. So we can say this is one of the most practical, you know, most practical topic that we need to discuss. So today we are not going to discuss any, you know, theory. We are not going to discuss any definitions of startup or entrepreneurship, because I know most of you have already studied the theories and definition of the startup. But today we are going to discuss about the real practical journey of my own startup, that what I have done. So I request and appreciate to each one of you, please participate into the conversation. I don't want this conversation should not be a one-way communication. I am the speaker, but I don't want I should only speak for entire 1 hour. I appreciate and request everyone to participate. It should be an interactive session. It should be a session that each one of you should learn at least something about the entrepreneurship and startup. And after completion of this session, I am looking that some of you will be motivated towards open your own startup and venture. So guys, if we talk about the entrepreneurship on startup, so we need, this is not, we cannot cover into a 1 hour or 2 hour. It is a, you know, it is a long discussion topic that we can discuss lot many things. So that we cannot cover in 1 hour, but we will try, I will try my level best. Whatever I have faced in my own startup, I will discuss my journey, my views with you all. So I wish and I hope that you will enjoy the session. So if we talk about the entrepreneurship, so entrepreneurship is not new. Entrepreneurship is very old. You know, it's the term is very old. Our fathers, our forefathers are into a business. Most of the families are doing their family businesses. That will also come to the entrepreneurs. My father is doing business, so he is entrepreneur from last 60 years, right? And most of the family members, most of the families of your families are also doing the business. So they are entrepreneurs. But now there is a certain change from businesses to the entrepreneurs. How? Earlier, if my father is doing the business, he's entrepreneur. But nowadays, if you want to start up your venture or business, so in that case, you need to add an innovation in your business. So this is the slight change from businesses to entrepreneurs. Now businesses, if we add innovation into a business, that will call the entrepreneur, right? So if we talk about the entrepreneurship, we cannot forget the name. We all admire one person who started the ventures from the name of that person. We call he is a real entrepreneur. Any one of you can please tell me the name of that person? जिसको हम बता सकते हैं he is the you know founder of entrepreneurship. जिसके नाम पे हम बोलते हैं कि he is a real entrepreneur. Any one of you can please tell me the name? Just wait. I would like to share one video before starting up the session. So that will give you the, you know, main, you will get a gist of the name of that person to whom we admire the most. Although there are big names in your market, those who are the, you know, famous
startup stories in association with Olook.in.
Let's have a look of that video.
Fiery instinct, futuristic outlook, indomitable will and a burning passion was all that Dhirubhai Ambani had when he set out to work his way for a living in the lanes of Bombay way back in 1958. From being a spice dealer to a cloth merchant to a textile producer, it was his ambition, inexhaustible energy and a never-say-die spirit that led him through all the obstacles to emerge as the business tycoon of India. He established and laid the foundation for Reliance Industries, which has today become one of the largest conglomerates in the world. Today, we talk about the success story of Dhirubhai Ambani, which is a legacy that would serve as an inspiration for generations to come. Dhirubhai Ambani was born to Hirachand Govardhan Das Ambani and Jamna Ben in the village of Chorwad, Junagadh district. His father was employed as a school teacher while his mother was a homemaker. Raised in frugal living conditions right from an early age, he was aware of the insufficiencies that the family dealt due to the small income of his father and larger expenses. Well, Dhirubhai Ambani was just 26 but had already given enough indications of his money-making abilities. However, his family conditions forced him to take a job and he started working as a petrol pump attendant and then as a clerk in an oil company. Later, he went to Aden in Yemen and took up a clerical job at Bessian Company, which was one of the largest transcontinental trading firm. Curious to learn the tricks of the trade, he soon started working simultaneously for a Gujarati trading firm. It was there he learned accounting, bookkeeping and preparing shipping papers and documents. He also acquired the skill of dealing with banks and insurance companies. Meanwhile, Yemeni movement for independence curtailed opportunities for Indians living in Aden. Thus, he moved back to India in 1958 and started exploring business opportunities in Bombay. Since he could not make large investments, he settled as a spice trader under the name Reliance Commercial Corporations. He soon started trading spices and sugar to Gulf Emirates. He initially focused on low profits, high volumes and rich quality. Well, not the one to be easily contented. He soon shifted focus to yarn trading. Though this had high level of risks involved, it did promise richer dividends. Later, as a first step to fulfill his dream of setting up a manufacturing unit, he started setting up a textile mill in Naroda, Ahmedabad in 1966. Every weekend, he flew from Bombay to Ahmedabad to check on the progress of the establishment of the factory and troubleshoot any problems faced by the workers. His main aim was to produce the best quality nylon in the quickest way possible and in large quantities. Later, with the value of Indian rupee falling down drastically, it steepened the project costs. Nevertheless, not the one to get scared of taking risk, he continued with the project. By August 1966, the construction work had finished and the equipment and machineries were being installed to start off with the productions. However, the new company had no buyers in the market, as the wholesalers refused to buy any fabric from Reliance at the instance of established big mill owners. Not the one to accept defeat, he soon stepped out on the road and started selling his stock directly to the retailers. His daring attitude and gutsy behavior impressed everyone, and soon, the market for Vimal, the name of his fabric, grew and started expanding. Well, in no time, it became the finest and the best-selling fashion fabric. By 1972, Reliance became huge and thriving, which was a stark contrast to its starting days. 3 years later, it received a nod of excellence from the World Bank, which speeded the upgradation and expansion of all plant operations. Between 1984 and 1996, the mill experienced a grand makeover, with his sons Mukesh and Anil joining the forces and started deploying computerized and high-tech machines while replacing the old and traditional ones, making Reliance the grandest composite mill in the country. Over the period of time, the Reliance Industries diversified into other sectors such as power, retail, textile, energy and many others, which ultimately made it as one of the biggest conglomerates in the world. Well, Dhirubhai Ambani was the mastermind, the initiator, conceptualizer and the visualizer behind the Reliance Group. Starting off as a mere yarn dealer, he rewrote history by establishing Reliance Industries at grassroots level and making it the largest business empire in India. He was also conferred with numerous honors, including Dean's Medal, Lifetime Achievement Award for Corporate Excellence and the Man of the Century Award. Dhirubhai Ambani's greatest achievement was that he showed Indians what was possible. With no Oxford or Yale degree and no family capital, he achieved what no one could even imagine. No one could have thought that the man who arrived in Mumbai with just 500 rupees in his pocket would later be ranked by Forbes as one of the world's richest person with an estimated net worth of $2.9 billion in 2002. It was through his futuristic vision and strong business acumen that Reliance Industries created history in the world of business. But it is for everyone to learn that capital in hand will not make you what you want to be. It all comes with hard work, focus and dedication.
Yes, so this is one of the most motivating video that I have ever seen. We have seen lot many things in this video. Just 500 rupees into the pocket from Gujarat to Mumbai, and now the one of the richest group in the world, one of the richest group in the world. So you have seen that the person who belongs from a village, from a lower middle class family, and now he is Reliance is one of the richest group in the world. So that all are the visionary approach. As we have seen into the last slide, that's capital. Without any family capital, family support or anything, he has set up his own empire. We have seen one or two more thing in that video, that is, he has worked as an attendant at a petrol pump. Petrol pump pe attendant ka kaam karne ke baad, now Reliance Industries, Reliance Refinery is one of the largest refinery in India. तो इंडिया में सबसे बड़ी रिफाइनरी है. जब कभी धीरूभाई अंबानी जी ने वहां पे पेट्रोल अटेंडेंट का काम किया था, नाउ ही हैज टेकन अ विजन टू ओपन हिज ओन रिफाइनरी. सो हम लोगों के माइंड में एक क्वेश्चन आता है, ऑलवेज वी टू का क्वेश्चन इन टू आर माइंड कि जब मेरे पास पैसे होंगे, कैपिटल होगी, तभी आई कैन डू माई ओन बिजनेस. नो, दिस इज रॉन्ग. This that video shows that without capital also you can set up and start up your own venture. Second misconception in our mind was ki I belongs from village, I belongs from that area, I belong from Hindi medium, I belong from this medium, I belong from this. Even this, there is a misconception of the people is that only IIT and IIMs people can go for a entrepreneurship and startup. नॉर्मली क्या होता है, हमने अभी जितने भी नेम सुने हैं एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप और स्टार्टअप के, दैट आर द वेल नोन नेम्स फ्रॉम आईआईटीज एंड आईएम्स. नो, दैट इज नॉट ट्रू. द पर्सन फ्रॉम अ सिंपल फैमिली बैकग्राउंड विदाउट कैपिटल, विदाउट एनी नॉलेज, बट दे हैज अ बिजनेस एक्यूमन, दे हैव अ डेडिकेशन टू वर्क, दे हैव अ सेंस ऑफ हार्ड वर्किंग, ही कैन सेट अप इंडियाज लार्जेस्ट, इवन एशिया एंड वर्ल्ड लार्ज, वन ऑफ द लार्जेस्ट इंडस्ट्री विदाउट एनी कैपिटल. So we have to remove all this misconception in our mind ki mere pe capital hogi ya fir main ek acche school se, I will be from CBSE or I will be from ICSE board, then only I can go for a entrepreneurship. This is the perfect example for all of us that we can see and we can motivate to see him ki ek normal family se, gareeb family se, ek student jo gaon se city mein aaya aur just for 500 rupees he has started his own venture. And the second misconception is what? एक biggest जो misconception है हम लोगों के mind में, even मेरे mind में भी था, वो misconception क्या था? What will be the right age for the entrepreneurship? Entrepreneurship की right age क्या होनी चाहिए? हम लोग हमेशा ये सोचते हैं entrepreneurship के लिए अभी मैं I am doing my UG, I am doing my post graduation. After do I will do some job for, I will do job for 5 years, 10 years, then I will go for entrepreneurship. No. There is no limit bar and age for the entrepreneurship. Even recently you will get the maximum example of the entrepreneurship who has just started their venture at the age of 16, at the age of 18, or at the age of 18 or 19 they are the billionaires. You can see lot many examples, and might be you, everybody will know the name founder of the Facebook. What is his age? If he will think after doing a job for some years, 10 years or 15 years, I will do my start my own venture, so that will not a good choice, that will not a good option. So I will suggest and I will advise to everybody, as soon as possible you think for entrepreneurship, you must start your entrepreneurship journey, because as soon as we will start the entrepreneurship, that the risk taking capacity will be high. Once you will be the some responsibility of your family, it will be the responsibility of the society, so it will be very difficult to appetite the risk. But at the time, at the age of the 18 or 16, you have a ability to taking more risk. So this is the right time to start your venture, to think about to start your entrepreneurship. I think most of the students who are joining this session are the age of 18 to 22. So I think this is the right age and this is the right platform for everybody to start the own venture. Even once I started my own venture, it was very difficult for me. Reason being, there was no support by the government. But we are fortunate enough that nowadays government is providing a wonderful platform and opportunity for the new startups. In terms of the finance, in terms of the technology, in terms of lot many agencies are involved to provide the assistance to the new entrepreneurs. We will discuss into the PPT ki government humko kaun-kaun si opportunities provide kar rahi hai, on what all are the challenges. Ek practical challenges kya aate hain? Sabse bada challenge jo aayega aap logo ke mind mein, that I know, wo abhi hum ek PPT mein discuss karenge, that I show the PPT with you all. I think this is visible to everyone.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, fine. So this is the topic. UR Services is my own venture, is my baby. So UR Services क्या है, ये क्या करती है, इसके बारे में हम डिस्कस करेंगे. And obviously this is the my story, this is the topic, and this is the logo of my company. And I will tell you, being an entrepreneur, being a startup, you have to do each and everything by yourself. No one is there to help you out. So it was very difficult to finalize the logo, to finalize the designing. So each and everything you have to done by yourself. So move ahead. So this is our, UR is a, you know, is a brand. And under this UR, we have two companies, United Resourcing and United Republic. So this is the UR group companies. Under United Resourcing, we are doing the education venture. We are doing the career services. We are doing the skilling. Under United Republic, we are doing the financial advisory. We are doing the tours and travel management services. So this is the all about the UR of both the companies. So just let's move ahead. So this is about United Resourcing Services Private Limited, that's partnering in your entrepreneurship plan. Yes, we are the, you know, is a brainchild of group of entrepreneurs, professional, conceptualized or to define the Industry Academia initiative, and a firm providing end-to-end knowledge, design, delivery, and international tie-up, field of exchange program, knowledge sharing, skill development, advisory services. What was the objective to form this company was, so I start about my journey. So I belong to a middle class family. I have done my 10 and 10 plus 2 from Hindi medium board, UP board. I have done my BCom from Hindu College, Muradabad. I have completed my master's in business administration from UP Technical University. So I got a first platform and first chance at the time of 2010 mein mere ko ek platform mila that I got selected in Reliance. It was the Reliance Capital under Anil Dhirubhai Ambani Group. So this was the, you know, turning point of my career where I started my corporate journey, one of the biggest group of the country. So it was very difficult to even get this job because it's very difficult. Again, I am telling you, at that time it was very difficult being from Hindi medium, being from normal, if you're normally doing your, you know, BCom and the city like Muradabad. So Reliance mein aapko ek opportunity mili. So I started my corporate journey from 2010 and 2014 tak maine wahan kaam kiya as a financial advisor. It was the Reliance Capital Group company. So I was the financial advisory. It was the broking firm where I look after the equity, commodity, currency segment. And in 2014, I got an opportunity to through the internal job posting. You must know the IJP. Companies mein IJPs aati hain. From that IJP, I switched my profile and I come to the education venture. Initiative behind to launch the education venture was to minimize the gap between the industry and academia. What we have seen, there is a huge gap between the industry and academia. Universities are preparing the candidates like a factory. Means we are creating the labor, but industries are not recognizing their labors. Industry ko jo human resource chahiye, wo apne need, they are looking the human resource as per their requirements. They are not bothered about your MBA, they are not bothered about your BTech, they are not bothered about any of your degree. They need the skills. So industry is looking the candidates, those who have skills, right? So in that case, what we have observed and we have approached to many corporates to find out what all are the reason. Jab hum universities or institution ke paas jaate hain, to humko pata ye lagta hai ki there is a, you know, students are, they are not getting a good job placements, they are not getting a good career options. और जब हम कॉर्पोरेट्स के पास जाते हैं तो कॉर्पोरेट्स हमको ये बोलता है कि वी आर नॉट गेटिंग अ गुड ह्यूमन रिसोर्स. तो प्रॉब्लम क्या है? यूनिवर्सिटीज और कॉलेजेस के पास बच्चे बहुत हैं, जो अभी अनएम्प्लॉयड हैं, अभी जो पास आउट हो रहे हैं, ये कॉर्पोरेट्स और इंडस्ट्री के पास बहुत सारी रिक्वायरमेंट्स हैं जॉब की. सो वेयर इज द गैप, ये फुलफिल क्यों नहीं हो रहा है? सो वी फाउंड द रीजन दैट इंडस्ट्री इज लुकिंग द कैंडिडेट दोज हु हैव स्किल्स. उनको स्किल्स चाहिए. पहले क्या होता था, कंपनी अपने अकॉर्डिंग बच्चों को ट्रेन करती थी. नाउ अ डे सिनेरियो हैज बीन चेंज्ड. कंपनीज को बच्चे चाहिए जो दोज हु आर रेडीमेड. कंपनीज के पास टाइम नहीं है कि उनको ट्रेन करें. कंपनी वॉन्ट्स द ह्यूमन रिसोर्स दोज हु आर द एसेट्स फॉर देम, दे डोंट वॉन्ट द लाइबिलिटी. फर्स्ट डे से जो काम कर सके, फर्स्ट डे से जो परफॉर्म कर सके, जो बिजनेस की टर्मोलॉजी समझ सके, जो टेक्नोलॉजी को समझ सके, उनको ऐसे कैंडिडेट्स चाहिए. अब हमारा जो सिलेबस है जो हम पढ़ रहे हैं वो तो इस तरीके से बना नहीं है. वो तो हमको पेपर में लिखना होता है और जितने पेजेस हम भर के आएंगे उतने ज्यादा हमको मार्क्स मिलेंगे. बट इंडस्ट्री इज हार्डली बॉर्डर फॉर द सेम. इंडस्ट्री रिक्वायर्स द टैलेंट. इन दैट केस वी हैव टेकिंग द रिक्वायरमेंट फ्रॉम द इंडस्ट्री व्हाट दे आर लुकिंग फॉर टू द न्यू फ्रेशर्स एंड वी हैव अप्रोच टू द यूनिवर्सिटीज और इंस्टीट्यूशन दैट दिस इज द इंडस्ट्री रिक्वायरमेंट्स. So after discussion with the authorities of the panel of the universities, we have come into the conclusion that we have to change our syllabus. So we have to design the syllabus in such a way जहाँ पे आपके academics और industry दोनों की requirements fulfill होती हैं, right? So under this venture with Reliance, we have start to launch the programs. We were the industry interface partner, right? So this was the wonderful period for me. From 2010 to 2016. So what happened in 2016? Reliance has shut their ventures. So it was very difficult for me what to do. अगर आप एक छह साल एक अच्छे corporates में काम कर लेते हैं तो what you will do? Either you have to switch with some of the company. Or what was the chance? I have think to go for an entrepreneurship. I just started my own venture in the year 2016 and I formed this United Resourcing Services Limited. Under this, we have started with the industry interface partner, education vertical, student action, domestic and international, skill vertical, career services. Here I want to, I'm very much thankful to Tirthankar Mahavir University for providing me such a wonderful platform, because I am associated with Tirthankar Mahavir University as an associate industry partner from 2012. And I'm thankful to the university for providing me the platform, opportunity to grow up my startup. University ne mujhe place provide kara, ek opportunity provide kari. Aur 2014 mein we have signed a one MOU with Tirthankar Mahavir University jo abhi tak run ho raha hai. After this, with the help of the Tirthankar Mahavir University, we have made our presence in entire North India. We have a collaboration and tie-ups with top of the most universities in North India. We have a collaboration with international universities also. We have a collaboration with the industry also. But I am thankful to the Tirthankar Mahavir University to providing me the opportunity to start my own venture. So under this, we are doing the financial advisory and tour and travel business. So we have a corporate association also. Corporate association, we have a collaboration with the SDFC and Future Group. We are the associate partner with both of the group. Both of the group are the giant of the industry. HDFC is one of the most, promising and giant of the financial services, and Future Group now is a part of the Reliance Industries, is one of the giant of the retail segment. So both the corporates, we have an association with both of the corporates. Along with this corporates, we have an association with the different corporates, those who are providing us a different opportunity to our candidates, right? So here we are starting the functions that we follow. This was the very important slides that we're going to discuss. कि क्या functions थे जो हमने follow करे और कहाँ पे हमको problems आई. सबसे बड़ी problems क्या आई 2016 में, you must know, what all are the three magical words जो हर कोई सुनना चाहता है. What all the three magical words? Yes, anyone? चलिए, वो थ्री मैजिकल वर्ड्स होते हैं सैलरी इज क्रेडिटेड. जब आपके पास एक मैसेज आता है ना 30th को 30 तारीख को जो एक मैसेज आता है आपके मोबाइल फोन पे, सैलरी इज क्रेडिटेड, सो उससे मतलब वो मैसेज देखने के बाद जो खुशी मिलती है वो खुशी आपको कभी नहीं मिलेगी. सो दिस वॉज द इम्पोर्टेंट मैसेज, सैलरी इज क्रेडिटेड. लेकिन जब आप जॉब छोड़ते हैं तो वो मैसेज आना बंद हो जाता है. सो यू विल नेवर लिसन दैट 3 मैजिकल वर्ड, सैलरी इज क्रेडिटेड. सो दिस इज वन ऑफ द, यू नो, यू विल नेवर गेट इन टू द एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप दैट सैलरी इज क्रेडिटेड. इन अ जॉब दिस इज द वन ऑफ द मोस्ट प्रोमिसिंग वर्ड दैट यू विल रिसीव एवरी मंथ, सैलरी इज क्रेडिटेड. सो वी आर स्टिल मिसिंग दैट वर्ड, सैलरी इज क्रेडिटेड. सो फंक्शन दैट वी फॉलो, हमने क्या फॉलो किया? Assumption of risk. सबसे पहले हमने ये फॉलो किया कि what all are the risk involved into the business. I'm telling you guys, I just started my own venture with the amount of 10,000 rupees. I just started my this both the companies with 10,000 rupees. There is no fund is involved. I have not taken a single amount of loan from anyone. I just started with 10,000 rupees. And fortunately, I'm proud to say this time our company turnover is 10 million. In just tenure of the 4 years, from 10,000 to 1 crore rupees. So I'm proudly said that this is the beauty of the entrepreneurship. So ab wo teen word miss to karenge, but the profit that you will enjoy, that you will never think. 10,000 to 1 crore. This is the, you know, one of the biggest achievement that I have ever seen in me. Function that we follow the assumption of risk. So risk to humare paas kuch tha hi nahi. I left my job. Even I left my job, I'm getting a salary of 50,000 rupees. It was the biggest risk, but I have taken that risk. Maine wo ek risk liya, 50,000 rupees ki salary ko drop out kiya, and I started my own venture. और मैंने 10,000 रुपए इस वेंचर में इन्वेस्ट किए. तो इट वाज द अजम्पशन ऑफ रिस्क, हमने अज्यूम करा रिस्क को, एंड स्टिल वी आर टेकिंग अ अजम्पशन ऑफ द रिस्क इनटू आवर बिजनेस. कितना रिस्क है, हायर द रिस्क हायर द रिटर्न, दिस इज द पॉलिसी आप लोगों ने पढ़ी भी होगी. सेकंड इज अ बिजनेस डिसीजन, दैट इज वन ऑफ द इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट दैट बिजनेस डिसीजन. डिसीजंस क्या होते हैं, बिकॉज बीइंग अ यू नो इन योर स्टार्टअप यू हैव टू टेक each and every decision by yourself. No one is there to help you out. Aapko sare decisions lene hain. How? Office kahan set up karna hai? Human resource kaise rakhna hai? Kitna fund kahan pe invest karna hai? Kaise expansion karna hai? So you have to do each and every business decision by yourself. You know, managerial functions. Ye function sabse toughest hai. Managerial functions kya hote hain? मैनेजरियल फंक्शंस क्या होते हैं कि बीइंग एज मैम एज शेयरिंग माय प्रोफाइल आई एम द सीईओ एंड डायरेक्टर. नो, आई नेवर टेल दैट आई एम द सीईओ. आई एम द असिस्टेंट मैनेजर, आई एम द मैनेजर, आई एम द मार्केटिंग मैनेजर, आई एम द ह्यूमन रिसोर्स मैनेजर, आई एम द प्रोडक्शन मैनेजर, आई एम द आईटी मैनेजर, आई एम द ट्रैवल मैनेजर. सो बीइंग अ स्टार्टअप और बीइंग अ न्यू एंटरप्रेन्योर, यू आर द मैनेजर ऑफ ऑल द डिपार्टमेंट्स. क्योंकि आपके यहाँ पे डिपार्टमेंट्स नहीं होते हैं नए स्टार्टअप्स में. यू हैव टू डू ईच एंड एवरीथिंग बाय योरसेल्फ. नो वन इज देयर टू हेल्प यू आउट. स्टार्टिंग में अपने ऑफिस का लॉक खोलने से लेके बंद करने से लेके सारे काम, इवन फर्नीचर सेटअप करने से लेके कंप्यूटर सेटअप लगाने तक का काम हमने खुद किया है. सो दैट आर द मैनेजरियल फंक्शंस. यू हैव टू मैनेज ऑल द डिपार्टमेंट्स बाय योरसेल्फ. कॉर्पोरेट जैसा नहीं है, ट्रैवल डेस्क अलग है आपकी, एचआर डिपार्टमेंट अलग है, प्रोडक्शन डिपार्टमेंट अलग है. सो स्टार्टअप्स में यू हैव टू डू ऑल द थिंग्स बाय योरसेल्फ. फंक्शंस ऑफ इनोवेशन क्या होते हैं? एज द इनोवेशन सेल इज देयर, इनोवेशन जब तक नहीं होगा आपके प्रोडक्ट में, आपकी सर्विस में, सो आपका स्टार्टअप सक्सेसफुल नहीं होगा. इट्स नॉट नेसेसरी कि आप जो भी प्रोडक्ट लेके आए इट ऑलवेज बी न्यू. आप सारी चीजें नई नहीं ला सकते, बट यू कैन add on, you can modify the old product with your innovation. आप पुराने product में पुरानी service में भी innovation add कर सकते हैं. It's not necessary कि सारी चीजें नहीं आएंगी. Old चीजें जो है वहां पर भी आप innovation ला सकते हैं. The last but most important point is networking and connections. This is the important suggestions for, you know, functions, networking and connections. आपके पास पैसा होता नहीं है, आपको लोग जानते नहीं है, आप क्या करेंगे? आपकी नेटवर्किंग, आपके कनेक्शन ही आपके लिए हेल्पफुल होंगे. दिस इज द की फंक्शन दैट न्यू एंटरप्रेन्योर्स हैज टू फोकस. अगर आप हमने नेटवर्किंग पे फोकस, कनेक्शंस पे फोकस किया थ्रू सोशल मीडिया साइट्स थ्रू आवर रिलेशनशिप दैट वी गॉट द कनेक्शंस वी गॉट द रेफरेंसेस एंड बाय द हेल्प ऑफ द नेटवर्किंग एंड कनेक्शंस वी आर एक्सपेंडिंग आवर बिजनेसेस इनटू डिफरेंट डिफरेंट स्टेट्स एंड द सिटीज राइट यस सो दिस इज द इंपॉर्टेंट स्लाइड अगेन प्रॉब्लम दैट वी फेस्ड lack of adequate finance money obviously hum bolte hain ki paise ki zarurat nahi padti but obviously this was the biggest problem that we faced finance nahi hota aapke paas aap finance kaise manage karenge it was very difficult abhi kya hota hai hum jab job mein jaate hain we got a office we got a ac you know ac office we are getting a you know personal laptop we are getting a personal pc we are getting each and everything pantry is there coffee machine is there we are getting everything but once you are go for a startup you have to set up each and everything by yourself to aap finance kahan se leke aayenge paisa kahan se milega abhi hum is pe aage discuss karenge ki isko jo funds hai wo humko kahan se mil sakte hain but this is the problem that we face high cost of setup again कॉस्टिंग प्रॉब्लम सेटअप की बहुत अगर आज मेरे को अपने ऑफिस में चार कंप्यूटर चार पीसी एक एसी एक मशीन सेटअप करनी हो तो दैट विल बी अ ह्यूज कॉस्ट दैट इज द एडमिनिस्ट्रेटिव कॉस्ट आई हैव टू पुट सो हाई कॉस्ट ऑफ सेटअप इट वाज द बिगेस्ट चैलेंज इन आवर स्टार्टअप अनफेवरेबल मार्केट कंडीशन मार्केट जो होता है वो आपके जो कंडीशन होती है मार्केट की वो आपके फेवर में नहीं होती बहुत सारे लोग ये चाहेंगे दे विल पुल यू डाउन वो आपको दे विल नॉट बी हैप्पी दैट यू आर ग्रोइंग कंडीशंस नहीं होंगी आपका काम बनते हुए भी पीपल वांट कि ये काम ना हो अनफेवरेबल मार्केट कंडीशंस आपकी ब्रांड नहीं है आपकी रिकॉग्निशन नहीं है पीपल विल नॉट ट्रस्ट यू आप कैसे करेंगे आप न्यू हैं दिस वाज़ द रियल एग्जांपल विद मी जब मैं किसी यूनिवर्सिटीज के साथ वंस आई वॉज विद रिलायंस आई गो आई गॉट अ गुड रेस्पॉन्स बट आई गो आफ्टर इनिशिएटिंग माई ओन वेंचर आई गो विद द यूनिवर्सिटी it was the you know people are not trusting you they are not happy with you they are doubtful that whether you will be successful or not so this is the you know biggest challenge that we have faced point number 4 that unfavorable human resource still we are facing this problem yet is very difficult task to set up a human resource आप मशीनों से तो काम करा सकते हैं बट पीपल लोगों से काम कराना बहुत डिफिकल्ट है सो वी आर नॉट गेटिंग अ गुड ह्यूमन रिसोर्स येट सो दिस इज द बिगेस्ट चैलेंज दैट वी हैव फेस्ड ह्यूमन रिसोर्स आपको अच्छे नहीं मिलते अच्छे लोग आपको नहीं मिलते बिकॉज बीइंग अ स्टार्टअप यू कैन नॉट पे अ गुड सैलरी तो आपको ऐसे लोग चाहिए जो पैशनेट हों जो अपने करियर को दे कैन गिव यू 2 to 3 years दे कैन डू अ हार्ड वर्क बिकॉज बीइंग अ एंटरप्रेन्योर देयर इज नो हॉलीडे You have to work 24 hours. You have to work 24 into 365. So, ऐसे लोग आपको मुश्किल से मिलेंगे. Complex rules, regulation, procedure of by the government. Company कैसे setup करनी है, taxation कैसे करना है, GST कैसे देना है. That is the rules are very complex. You need to hire a CA, CS. So all these are a very complex process. This academic system are built for jobs. हम सब लोग पढ़ रहे हैं. हमने भी पढ़ा है आप भी पढ़ रहे हैं दैट एकेडमिक सिस्टम्स आर बिल्ट फॉर अ जॉब कोई भी सिस्टम में ये नहीं पढ़ाया जाता कि एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप को कैसे सक्सेसफुल बनाना है एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप के लिए आपको क्या करना है बिकॉज हमारा जो एकेडमिक सिस्टम है वो जॉब्स के लिए बना है MBA करिए BTech करिए और ये कंपनी प्लेसमेंट्स के लिए आएगी जॉब लीजिए सिस्टम इज नॉट फॉर अ एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप दैट इज फॉर द जॉब्स हमको जॉब्स लेने के लिए पढ़ाया जाता है एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप के लिए नहीं पढ़ाया जाता नॉट कंसिडर्ड टू बी अ रेस्पेक्टेबल जॉब्स स्टार्टिंग में लोग आपको दे विल नॉट ट्रीटेड एज अ रेस्पेक्टेबल जॉब आप अपना काम कर रहे हैं दे विल नॉट ट्रीटेड यू अ गुड माइंडसेट ऑफ द पीपल फियरिंग फेलियर सबसे प्रॉब्लम जो आई वो ये प्रॉब्लम आई हमारे स्टार्टअप में कि फेल्योर का फियर फियर फैक्टर सबसे टफेस्ट था कि हम सक्सेसफुल होंगे या नहीं होंगे सक्सेसफुल होंगे या नहीं होंगे बट आई सजेस्ट एंड रिकमेंड इफ यू स्पेंड फ्यू आवर्स फ्यू डेज फ्यू मंथ्स इनटू अवर स्टार्टअप देन यू विल फेस अ सच लेवल ऑफ कॉन्फिडेंस रीपेइंग लोन एंड क्रेडिट्स अगर आपने अपने स्टार्टअप में लोन लिया है तो आप उसको कैसे रीपे करेंगे सो देयर आर अ फ्यू सजेशंस फॉर द यंग एंटरप्रेन्योर So here I want to give some few suggestions to the young entrepreneur, those who want to start up their own venture. Strong leadership qualities. Leadership की qualities आप में होनी चाहिए, motivation qualities आप में होनी चाहिए, risk taking qualities आप में होनी चाहिए. Whether you have a finance or not, but you have a leadership quality, you have a motivational qualities, you are confident enough, your startup and your entrepreneurship will be get success. Strong sense of basic ethics and integrity. ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है नए एंटरप्रेन्योर्स के लिए, एथिक्स और इंटेग्रिटी. हमको बहुत ही स्टार्टिंग में बहुत अच्छे ऑफर्स आए, बट दैट वर नॉट द एथिकल ऑफर्स. अगर पैसे के लालच में हम उन ऑफर्स को एक्सेप्ट कर लेते तो आज जो मार्केट में रेपुटेशन हमने बनाई है, अपने क्लाइंट्स का रेपुटेशन बनाई है, वो हम रेपुटेशन स्पॉइल कर देते. सो दिस इज माई सजेशन टू द यंग एंटरप्रेन्योर, वर्क विद एथिक्स. अगर इंटीग्रिटी से आप काम करेंगे, आप कम प्रॉफिट्स पे काम करिए, बट इंटीग्रिटी और एथिक्स के साथ काम करिए. अगर आप एथिक्स के साथ काम करेंगे तो योर स्टार्टअप विल गो फॉर अ लॉन्ग रन. विलिंगनेस टू फेल. अभी जो फेयर था, अगर आप फेलियर के लिए रेडी हैं, अगर आप ये सोचते हैं कोई वर्क को आप इस तरीके से करते हैं कि आई एम रेडी टू टेक द फेलियर, सो डेफिनेटली यू विल बी गेट सक्सेस. सीरियल इनोवेटर्स, ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट है. इनोवेशन आपको टाइम टू टाइम ऐड करने पड़ेंगे अपने स्टार्टअप में. टाइम टू टाइम आपको इनोवेशन वाली जो चीजें हैं वो ऐड करनी होंगी, ताकि योर क्लाइंट्स विल बी गेट मोटिवेटेड, वो आप और रैपिडली यू विल गेट योर ऑर्डर्स एंड योर क्लाइंट्स कैन बी सस्टेन. सेल्फ प्रमोशन, दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पॉइंट. हम लोग क्या होते हैं, स्टार्टिंग में जब हमने वेंचर स्टार्ट किया, नो वन नोज अबाउट योर सर्विसेज. We have just started. हमारे पास इतना बजट नहीं था कि हम नेशनल एड्स करें, पेपर में एड करें, अपनी ब्रांडिंग करें. तो वी जस्ट स्टार्टेड फॉर अ सेल्फ प्रमोशन. हमने सेल्फ प्रमोशन करना स्टार्ट किया, अपने आपको प्रमोट करना स्टार्ट करा थ्रू सोशल मीडिया साइट्स, थ्रू लिंक्डइन, थ्रू फेसबुक, थ्रू ट्विटर. सो पीपल जस्ट स्टार्टेड नोटिसिंग अस. हमको लोगों ने नोटिस करना स्टार्ट करा. तो नेवर बी अफ्रेड फॉर अ सेल्फ प्रमोशन. आप कोई भी काम करें, कोई भी अचीवमेंट लें, आप छोटा सा सर्टिफिकेट भी लें, ट्राई टू फॉर अ सेल्फ प्रमोशन. जब तक आप सेल्फ प्रमोशन नहीं करेंगे, पीपल विल नॉट रिकॉग्नाइज यू. एक छोटे से छोटा अचीवमेंट को भी आपको सेल्फ प्रमोट करना है, बिकॉज बीइंग अ स्टार्टअप आपके पास यू डोंट हैव एनफ मनी एंड फंड्स टू प्रमोट योर प्रमोशन एट अ नेशनल लेवल विद द एड्स और द यू नो डिजिटल मोड. कॉम्पिटिटिव स्प्रिट, कॉम्पिटिशन हमेशा हमको रखना पड़ेगा. अंडरस्टैंड द वैल्यू ऑफ द स्ट्रॉन्ग पीर नेटवर्क. नेटवर्किंग, आपके जो कलीग्स हैं उसके साथ आपको स्ट्रॉन्ग पीर नेटवर्किंग रखनी होगी. सो अगेन हेयर आई वॉन्ट टू डिस्कस द गवर्नमेंट, अबाउट द गवर्नमेंट, वॉट गवर्नमेंट इज डूइंग फॉर द एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप, वॉट इज द रोल ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट. एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप डेवलपमेंट प्रोग्राम. Government is providing the free of cost entrepreneurship development program for the young entrepreneur. Even if you are thinking to start your own venture, you can register yourself for an entrepreneurship development program in which you will learn, you will get a skill and knowledge through structured training and institution building program. That is free of cost. आप इसमें रजिस्टर्ड कर सकते हैं एंड यू विल गेट अपॉर्चुनिटी टू लर्न अबाउट द एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप. राइट, आफ्टर इंडिपेंडेंस गवर्नमेंट का फोकस था बिजनेसेस को प्रमोट करने का, बट नाउ गवर्नमेंट इज फोकसिंग फॉर द एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप. आप लोगों ने गवर्नमेंट की बहुत सारी स्कीम्स के बारे में सुना होगा, दैट इज स्टार्टअप इंडिया, स्टैंड अप इंडिया, लोकल फॉर वोकल और स्मॉल एंड मीडियम स्केल इंडस्ट्रीज. Government has putting a lot many fund to all these sectors, to all these entrepreneurial activities. अगर आज आप अपना business start करना चाहते हैं, अपना entrepreneurship start करना चाहते हैं, तो there is no problem for the finance. There is no problem for the you know funds. You just submit your idea through incubation. You can get the fund. Incubation center में आप जा सकते हैं और through EDP you can register yourself for the fund also. So these are the few organization by the government, those who are providing the opportunity to the young entrepreneur through which you can register yourself. First is NISBD. I think aap logon ne naam suna hoga, or those who have not listened that name, please note it down, that National Institute for Entrepreneurship and Small Business Development. That is the highest body of the entrepreneurship. You can register yourself under this and you will get lot many things. You will get lot many opportunity by NISWAD. So you can register yourself in NISWAD. Second is EDII, Entrepreneurship Development Institute of India. It is a national institute set up by the public financial institution and government of Gujarat. Those people, those students who belongs from the rural areas, those belong to semi-urban areas, they can register. These are the organization who are supporting for the backward areas and special target groups in entrepreneurship. जो लोग villages में रहते हैं, जो लोग semi-urban areas में रहते हैं, they can go and visit this site, ADII, Entrepreneurship Development Institute of India, and you will get lot many opportunities under this banner. This is TCU. This is for the candidates who are want to open their startup and venture into the technology. That's technical consultancy organization. That's various state government in association with the Indian Financial Institution has promoted various technical consultancy organization to provide technical consultancy. Jo BTech students, jo technical students, they want to set up their venture into a technology, into a tech, they can register, they can take a help from TCO, that is a technical consultancy organization. Next is IIC, Indian Investment Center. It's an autonomous non-profit center promoted and supported by the government of India. Means that is the organization with the help of the foreign and Indian collaborative efforts. This is the non-profit organization जो इन्वेस्टमेंट के लिए हमको हेल्प करती है. इफ योर आइडिया इज परफेक्ट, यू आर गेटिंग अ सर्टिफिकेशन, देन देयर इज नो वरी अबाउट द फंड. सो ऑल दीज फोर आर द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. यू जस्ट टेक अ स्क्रीनशॉट ऑफ दिस, दैट विल रियली हेल्पफुल फॉर यू इफ यू वांट टू स्टार्ट अप योर ओन वेंचर. अलोंग विद दिस देयर इज अ नेशनल लेवल एंड स्टेट लेवल ऑर्गेनाइजेशन. राइट, नेशनल लेवल अगेन वी हैव अ सेवन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन जो हमको सपोर्ट करती हैं, जो हमको हेल्प करती हैं हमारे स्मॉल स्केल बिजनेसेस में, हमारे एंटरप्रेन्योरशिप में. ऑल द नेम्स आर मेंशनड हियर, यू कैन टेक अ स्क्रीनशॉट ऑफ दिस. एट स्टेट लेवल आल्सो ऑल दीस आर द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन जो हमको सपोर्ट करती हैं स्टेट लेवल पे अपने स्टार्टअप्स को प्रमोट करने के लिए. अर्लियर वी हैव डिस्कस अबाउट द अपेक्स बॉडी ऑफ द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, दोज हु आर सपोर्टिंग अस, एंड हियर वी आर डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द organization who are supporting at state level. So this is the NISWAD office. It offers more than 100 training programs in different field. This is the office at Noida, Uttar Pradesh. So these are the list, few list of the programs with the duration of the programs. Thus you can register yourself and you will get a certification without any cost. All these are the certification, few certification, but you can enroll more than 100 certification as per your requirements, free of cost into the entrepreneurship. So you can say you will get each and everything by the NISWAD related to the entrepreneurship. Right? So I have prepared one small quiz for you all. एक छोटा सा क्विज है आप लोगों के लिए. आई वॉन्ट कि आप उसमें पार्टिसिपेट करेंगे. दिस इज अ वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग क्विज और आप लोगों को समझ में आएगा और यू विल नो कि कौन कौन से हमारे एंटरप्रेन्योर्स हैं इंडिया में, जो दोज वर सक्सेसफुल एंटरप्रेन्योर. बट बिफोर दिस जस्ट आई वॉन्ट टू शो अ स्मॉल 1 minute वीडियो फॉर यू ऑल. सो वॉट एवर वी हैव डिस्कस टूडे, दिस इज द नटशेल ऑफ, वी विल सी द नटशेल इन दिस वीडियो. Just have a look.
Entrepreneurship is a journey. It's a journey of a risk taker. It's a journey of a game changer. It's a journey of a people facing failure. It's a journey of a people facing failure again and again. It's a journey of a high dreamer. It's a journey of the one who wants to give something to this world. It's a journey of the person who dreams of changing this world. Entrepreneurship is the journey of the people who doesn't know the meaning of give up. It's a journey of the people who has the courage to sign. It's a journey of the one who writes the definition of success. If you are a dreamer, you are a game changer, you are a risk taker, if you have a dream to change this world, if you have something to provide this world, you are most welcome to this journey. Let's take a challenge. Let's become a successful entrepreneur. Let's give something to this world. Let's change the world.
So, if you are a risk taker, if you want to take risk, the journey is yours. So you are most welcome to the Entrepreneurship Club. So there is lot many opportunities by the government. So let's move ahead, with our business quiz. Yes, please, now it's your turn to participate. List of 5 successful Indian entrepreneurs. आपको एक स्लाइड में एक फोटोग्राफ शो होगा एंड यू हैव टू गेस द नेम. आपको उनका नाम, यू हैव टू टेल द नेम ऑफ दैट वेंचर. द पर्सन इज मिस्टर सचिन वंसल. कैन यू प्लीज टेल मी एनीवन हु इज ही?
फ्लिपकार्ट.
यस, ही इज राइट. कंपनी इज फ्लिपकार्ट, इज द सीईओ. He started that in 2007 with the initial fund of 4 lakh rupees. Just go through that point. He started this company with just 4 lakh rupees, which translates to the $5,600. Sachin Vansal is co-founder and Vinny Vansal. $5,600 mein he just started this venture, and just you can see what the Flipkart is now. So, आप देखिए 2007 में उन्होंने स्टार्ट किया था फ्लिपकार्ट. विजय शेखर शर्मा. यस गाइस, कम ऑन, हु इज ही?
पेटीएम फाउंडर ऑफ पेटीएम.
यस, यू आर राइट, पेटीएम फाउंडर. ही आप ये पढ़िए, आप इनकी हिस्ट्री पढ़िए. एट व्हाट अमाउंट ही हैज स्टार्टेड द पेटीएम, व्हाट ही इज टुडे. आप इनके फैक्ट्स पढ़िए. इन कॉलेज टाइम ही हैज सेट अप अ वेबसाइट जिसको ही सोल्ड फॉर द $1 million टू द स्टूडेंट्स हु आर डूइंग द बीटेक, हु आर डूइंग द नेटवर्किंग एंड हु आर डिजाइनिंग. Just see, in a development, he's make a website in a college life and sold his website into a $1 million. He was the entrepreneur of the year in 2016. Next, Ritesh Agarwal, who is he?
Oyorum.
Oyorums. सब देखिए आप, इनके पास अपना एक भी होटल नहीं है. ही डोंट हैव एनी सिंगल प्रमिसेस. वंस ही स्टार्टेड द बिजनेस, ही डोंट हैव एनी सिंगल होटल बिल्डिंग, बट एवरी ईयर वी आर गेटिंग द ओयू होटल्स. दिस इज द ब्यूटी ऑफ द टेक्नोलॉजी. विदाउट हैविंग द प्रॉपर्टी, विदाउट हैविंग द होटल, दे हैव अ मोर देन आई डोंट नो कितने सारे होटल्स. वी थ्रू द ऐप, थ्रू द टेक्नोलॉजी, they have tie up with the millions of hotels in India and outside India. We are getting the hotels, we are booking the hotels by the OYO app. Aur inke paas ek bhi property nahi hai. Ab aap padhiye, to one of the best story of an entrepreneur, because it's the clear example of having a business mind and constantly pushing yourself to the edge without holding anything back. Inke paas kuch nahi tha, there is nothing in this back. graduating from schools, moving to Delhi to pursue his dream to college in 2011. Within 2 years of going through the college years, he dropped out and got selected for the Peter Taylor Fellowship. After receiving, you know, $1 lakh, then app OU begin to see the success. Now he's a successful billionaire without having anything. Who is he? Bhavesh Agarwal.
So, Ola founders.
Ola founders.
Come again, please. आपकी आवाज क्लियर नहीं आ रही है.
Sir, Ola Cabs.
Ola Cab founder.
Yes, yes. Ola Cab. समझिए, what Ola Cab?
Ola Cab.
Ola Cab के पास अपनी कोई टैक्सी है?
No.
What they are doing? They are tying up, they are doing the connections, they are doing the networking, or through the help of the technology, they are the billionaire. उनके पास अपना कुछ नहीं है.
Yes, sir.
Sir.
Yes.
It's create own app Ola.
Yes, just created a app Ola app.
Yes.
Without investment, without having drivers, without having, you know, taxis, without having road permits, without registration, no insurance, nothing, no tension. Just they are playing with the technology. A recent example. Dhirubhai Ambani ka to humne ek bahut bada example, they were the oldest example that we have seen. But this all are the latest example. Ola, OEO, Paytm, Flipkart. कभी आपने सोचा था आज हम घर से बैठे हुए 10 रुपए का अगर हमको चाय पीनी है तो वी कैन पे 10 रुपीज बाय थ्रू यू नो ऑनलाइन. ई सेलर्स के पास हमारे पास ऐप है, आज उनके पास पेटीएम है, आज उनके पास फोन पे है. ब्यूटी आइडिया जनरेशन, आइडिया पे काम किया, दे हैव सेटअप कि हम करोड़ ऑफ रुपीज वी हैव टू इन्वेस्ट इनटू अ फैक्ट्री, मैन्युफैक्चरिंग करेंगे, सप्लाई गुड्स करेंगे. दे आर डूइंग विद द आइडिया, दे आर द बिलियनेयर विद द हेल्प ऑफ द आइडिया. सो दीज ऑल आर द रिसेंट एंड परफेक्ट एग्जांपल. ऑल आर द यंग पीपल लाइक यू, ऑल दीज हैव स्टार्टेड देयर वेंचर एट एज द एज ऑफ 18 एंड 20. दीज ऑल आर द परफेक्ट एग्जांपल. ऑल दीज आर द बिलियनेयर्स. यू कैन फॉलो देम ऑन लिंक्डइन, यू कैन फॉलो देम ऑन ट्विटर. आप अभी इनको रिक्वेस्ट भेजिए, आपकी रिक्वेस्ट एक्सेप्ट कर लेंगे. जस्ट चेक इट आउट. Who is he? Tell me.
Zomato.
Yes, Zomato. देखिए, all are the young entrepreneurs. इनके अपने होटल्स हैं क्या? They don't have any hotel. They don't have any restaurant. They are hiring any cooks, chef. What they are doing with the help of the app? They are doing all these things. Just see. आप इनकी हिस्ट्री पढ़िए, आप देखिए at what amount they have started their ventures. किसी ने they have not put the huge cost of investments. किसी ने कोई लोन नहीं लिया, किसी ने कोई इन्वेस्टमेंट नहीं करा. But now all these people are the billionaires of the country. They are running the country. And Ola Cab है या Zomato है या फिर Paytm है, आज हम सब लोगों के मोबाइल में सारे apps हैं. We are the habitual to use all these apps. So think yourself. Now it's your turn. You can think the idea. Koi bhi idea, as Dhirubhai Ambani said, ideas are no one's monopoly. Ideas are no one's monopoly. Think big, think ahead, and ideas are no one's monopoly. Just think your idea, generate your idea, register your idea. There is a lot many platform. Definitely you will get success. You will be the next billionaire and you will be the next most successful startup of the country. Let's see. Who is that person?
Mark Zuckerberg.
Mark Zuckerberg.
Yeah. The biggest risk is not taking any risk. In a world that is changing really quickly, the only strategy that is guaranteed to fail is not to taking risk. सबसे बड़ा रिस्क क्या है? आप कोई रिस्क ही ना लें, सबसे बड़ा रिस्क नहीं हो सकता. I hope some of you for a new idea, most of you will register your idea for entrepreneurship, and very soon we will see the new young blood will come to us for new business, new venture and new startups. So all the very best and good luck to all of you. Thank you all.